Hi, brothers and sisters in Christ. I want to share my testimony with you guys. I was a Muslim before. 4 years ago, I started to watch some YouTube videos about near-death experiences, NDE, if you want to research. And then I realized that everybody who has that experience saw Jesus after they die. So I was like thinking that even the Muslim people, and then I was like, why Muslim people, they don't see Muhammad? And I was just thinking about it, and then the more I research about it, and then I found out that Jesus is the way. I mean, everybody's seen Jesus, and I'm like, okay, because Quran says that Jesus was a prophet. I mean, Islam believes that Jesus was a prophet, so and he was a very good guy, and I knew about Jesus before, but and as a prophet, and I loved Jesus as a Muslim. And I was thinking about Jesus, and I'm like, okay, so Jesus was a very good person. He didn't do anything bad. He didn't do anything wrong. And he was holy, and he didn't do anything, any war, killing people, raping people. And I was just like thinking between these two people, Muhammad and Jesus, and I'm comparing those in my mind for like months. And then after I research, and I'm like, okay, I always loved Jesus. Even though I was a Muslim, I wasn't practicing in Islam, but even though I was a Muslim, I loved Jesus. Actually, I had a cross. Not this one. This one, my dear friend gave it to me, but the other cross I had, and sometimes I wear it. Even I was a Muslim, and when people ask me why you wearing cross, you're a Muslim, I would say I love Jesus. I am a Muslim, but I love Jesus. So in my mind, I'm like, okay, comparing these two people, and I'm like, I don't like the way Muhammad lived, and I like the way Jesus lived in this earth. And I'm like, okay, if I want to choose one, which one I'm going to choose? So in my mind, I'm like, okay, I like Jesus better. So I'm like, I choose Jesus. And then I find that I have to repent to God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob instead of Allah. And then, and I did it. One night I sit down and I said, God, Jesus, I believe in you and I love you. And I repent of all of my sins, and please forgive me. And then I just cried a little bit and said, I did this, I did that. I wasn't like big sinner, but yeah, sometimes we sin. So I lied and stuff. So I said, Jesus, please forgive me. And I repent. And I didn't know that everybody sees you after they died. So I don't want to go to hell. So please forgive me. And then when I went to bed, and I was half, completely asleep, half asleep and half awake. And then I was out of my spirit. I mean, out of my body, my spirit was out. And then I went to my steps in my house, next to the bedroom. And then I was looking down the stairs, and there was a guy over there with a white robe and like short, I mean, for guys is long, but for girls like this much hair, baby. And he was coming out up the stairs, and I'm like looking at him, and I'm like, don't tell me this is Jesus, because I didn't expect that Jesus is gonna come to my dream or vision, half dream, half vision. And I was like so surprised, and I said, don't tell me this is Jesus. And then he was coming upstairs to me, and the next scene I saw, he was right here, his face was right here, and I was looking at his face, and I'm sure you're gonna ask me, how did he look? So he was just an average looking guy, dark skin, big eyes, a little bit big nose. He wasn't like so attractive or not handsome. He was just an average guy, but so kind, looked so kind. So he was just looking at me in the second scene, and the third scene I saw my head was on his chest. I mean, he holding my head here, and then he was kissing my head, like here, several kisses. Okay, when I touch my head, I feel the same feeling. He was kissing. I mean, it was so real, the dream / vision, it was so real. So he was kissing my head, and I was like thinking that, why is he kissing my head? What that means, I don't know. And I was like thinking, Jesus is not handsome, and why is he kissing my head? And then I just woke up. I mean, I just came back, and then I was like, what in the world happened to me? Who was this guy? And I'm like, oh, so because I repented, he came to me. He was Jesus. And I'm like, oh, wow. With one repentance and one saying, God, I love you. I mean, Jesus, I love you. He is there in my house. And I'm like, okay. So I was happy. I was happy. So I was like, okay, I got my God. I got it. Because before I didn't know who's my God. So after two days, I started to praying, because I never prayed before that time. So I started to pray more. And after two days, I went to bed, and I was like half asleep and half awake. And my eyes was closed, and I saw a big ball of light. It was orangish and yellowish light coming out of it, and the surface of the ball was moving. Okay, it was like this, moving, and I'm looking at it with closed eyes, and I'm like, what in the world is happening? What is this big ball of light? And I'm like, what is it? And then it came to me, close to me, and while it came close to me, I'm hearing the wind sound, like whoosh, whoosh. And then I felt my blanket is up here when he came to me closer, and then I felt my blanket is here. And then I'm hearing the whooshing sound, and then it came close to me and close to me, and I'm looking at it, and then it goes inside of my chest and went inside my chest, and I'm like, what in the world is happening to me? And then it goes inside my chest, and I'm looking at myself, and I am glowing. I'm glowing like orangish and yellowish light, and I'm like, what is happening to me? And I got so surprised, and my hands was like this, close to my feet, and I'm like, okay, let me see if my hands are glowing too. So I lift up my hands, and then when I look at it, it was glowing, like a little bit glowing on my hands, and my hands was like this, and then everything stopped. That means the glowing stopped, and the light and the whooshing sound stopped. And also the wind, the energy of that thing stopped, and then my blanket fell on me, and I'm like this, and my blanket fell on me, and I'm like, what in the world happened to me? What was this? And I was just not surprised, but I didn't know what to do. And at the same time, when my blanket fall on me, I am feeling so much love in my heart. I mean, my heart was pulling up with love, unlimited love. And it takes like 2 seconds when I open my eyes, I'm feeling it open, and then stopped after like 2-3 seconds, and I'm like, because my heart was going up, my hands goes up more, and I was like this when everything stopped, and then I'm like, wow, this is the God. This is like supernatural from God. I couldn't believe it. And then I was so happy. I started to praise the Lord. And after like 5 minutes praising the Lord, I went back to sleep. And from until then, I was like, what was it? I have to know, what was it? I haven't read any Bible. I didn't know anything about Holy Spirit. Nothing, okay? Nothing. So I'm like, okay, I have to find a Bible. I have to read Bible, see what was it? And then I went to dollar store, and there it is, Bible. For $1, so I got 4 of them, and then I was like, oh, I don't know if I can understand this if I read it, and then I read it, and I'm like, I can understand it, and then I'm like, no, I want to read it so fast, I can't read it like this, so I got a Bible from one of my friends, in my language, so. Then I started to read it so fast, and then I got all of my answers in the Bible, and I got it when the Pentecost happened, and it was all in the Bible, and then I realized that, oh, that ball of light was Holy Spirit. And I am sealed with Holy Spirit, and I didn't know that. And I was so, so happy to find out that God chosen me, and God revealed himself to me, and I had a good choice. I mean, I made a right choice. So this is my testimony, and until then, Lots of supernatural stuff happening to me. I'm going to talk about it in other videos. So I hope and I pray that this testimony help and it encourages you, some of you, who don't know what's going on, and especially Muslim people. Please repent to the not Allah, repent to God of Abraham, Isaac and Jacob. Please ask God to wash your sins with his blood, precious blood, because Jesus did that. And God told me to tell you that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. So I'm doing what God wants me to do. So please go research by yourself and find out. This is not that because I say you have to obey. No, you go research and you're gonna find out. When you're gonna go to sleep tonight, you just ask, say, God, I don't know if Jesus is God or Allah is God or who is God, so please God, show yourself to me. And he's gonna do it in supernatural way, and he's doing it to, I mean, he did it for me, so he's gonna do for everybody that who asks. So God bless you all. Thank you for watching, and I'm gonna record another video for you. Thank you. Bye.